The Antonio Project presents LNG Part 1, The Story of LNG, Liquefied Natural Gas. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. And this time, I would like to share about LNG. LNG or liquefied natural gas, or some people say liquid natural gas. And this video will be consist of as follow: the extraction, liquefaction, transportation, regasification, and delivery to customer. There will be several video about LNG, especially about LNG carrier and FSRU. And this is part 1. The story of LNG. Let's check out the video.
Where do I start the story? The LNG story begin from the dawn of the earth, where the natural gas is commonly found. Natural gas is a fossil fuel energy source. Natural gas contain many different compounds. The largest component of natural gas is methane, a compound with one carbon atom and four hydrogen atom, or GH4. The geologist locates the types of geologic formations that are likely to contain natural gas deposits. Using seismic surveys on land and in the ocean to find the right places to drill natural gas and oil wells, then an exploratory well is drilled and tested. When the result from a test well show that a geologic formation has enough natural gas to make a profit, one or more production wells are drilled. Natural gas wells can be drilled vertically and horizontally into natural gas bearing formation. In conventional natural gas deposits, the natural gas generally flow easily up through wells to the surface. From the oil and gas well, natural gas is sent to processing plants, where water vapor and non-hydrocarbon compounds are removed and NGLs are separated from the wet gas. The product of natural gas processing plant are as follow: NGL or natural gas liquids, LPG or liquefied petroleum gas, LNG or liquefied natural gas, and condensate. For details, please watch my video in another part. On the liquefaction plant, natural gas being cooled down to liquid form for ease and safety of non-pressurized storage or transport. It takes about 1/600 the volume of natural gas in gaseous state at standard condition for temperature and pressure. The product from liquefaction plant then store on the LNG tank before distribute to customer, whether it is using pipeline, truck, or vessel. An LNG terminal then construct to transfer LNG from LNG tanks to LNG vessels. LNG vessel unload their cargo to customer, which are not connected to pipeline due to its distance and economical consideration. LNG terminal equipped with mooring equipment, jetty fender, mooring rolling arms, and other supporting equipment for berthing and unberthing of LNG vessels. A vessel nominated to call at the LNG terminal is required to undergo a ship shore compatibility study, or SSCS. Upon successful completion of the SSCS and approval, the vessel remains physically compatible for berthing at the LNG terminal. SSCS is carried out to ensure the safety, equipment suitability, and smooth LNG loading operation. A vessel called to LNG terminal require a pilot assistant for berthing. A designated harbor pilot station coordinate will be given by terminal authority as a pickup point. The number of tugboats required for berthing and unberthing assistant is depend into size of the LNG vessel. The larger the LNG carrier size, the greater the number of tugs required, or the greater horsepower tugboat deployed. At least 3 tugboats require for assistance during berthing or unberthing operation of LNG carrier. The berthing arrangement has been discussed and agreed among LNG terminal representative, LNG carrier master, and pilot. When LNG carrier has entering LNG terminal area, two tugboats will come closer to pick up towing line from LNG carrier. One tugboat fastened on the head and one tugboat fastened at stern. Two tugboats will assist of LNG carrier to make turn, to give additional brake power and pushing, to assist LNG carrier to make parallel with jetty approximately 100 meter off, with both of vapor manifold line while stopped in water. For details, you can watch my video, berthing operation of huge LNG carrier. LNG carrier arrival time is the time when the first line of LNG carrier spring line being hooked up to jetty mooring bollard. All mooring line will be hooked in accordance to agreed mooring arrangement. The sequence of sending mooring line is in accordance to master of LNG carrier decision. LNG carrier boat thruster when it is equipped also to be used during berthing or unberthing operation. During adjustment of mooring line, the position of vapor manifold to be keep aligned between terminal and LNG carrier. One person is always standby at the cargo manifold and reporting the LNG carrier distance at manifold alignment. When all mooring line has been booked and made fast, then LNG carrier will declare all fast and finish with engine. All mooring equipment will be stopped and engine will be secured. All assisting tugboat then will let go on their towing lines and stand by around the jetty for assistance in the event of emergencies. Following two stream of information given by LNG carrier, gangway rigged from terminal to LNG carrier for personal transfer. Optical cables, pneumatic or electric ESDS and bonding cable to be connected to establish communication and emergency shutdown system between LNG carrier and terminal. Next step is marine loading arm connection. There are three loading arms, with the arrangement are as follow. Vapor loading arm is on the center, and two other is liquid loading arms. Connect the loading arm one by one, and confirm that all of manifold lanes are in good condition. Then carry out oxygen purge using N2 to confirm that all oxygen inside of loading arm has been drawn out. Depend into the LNG tank temperature condition, whether under ready to load or not. Ready to load is the condition when the cargo tank temperature is acceptable for direct loading. Without additional tank cooling down, the required temperature for direct loading is about -120 degrees Celsius until -130 degrees Celsius. It is depend into terminal regulation. When the temperature below ready to load condition, the vessel is required to carry out tank cooling down and additional time and LNG is required for the cooling down. Water curtain then started to protect ship's hull in case of LNG leakage. ESDS strip test conducted 2 times, hot ESD or before arm and line cool down, and cold ESD after completion of arm and line cooling down. After escort safety checklist completed by both parties and cargo meeting agreed the sequence of loading rate, that opening CTMS is conducted. Arm cooling down and line cool down operation conducted after opening CTMS. Cargo loading started with slow rate and cargo pump started one by one. After confirm that all line and manifolds under normal condition, the cargo transfer to be rated up to full rate. During loading to be maintained, tank pressure about 800 mm aqua until 1000 mm aqua. Check the level periodically. Check ship's draft, mooring line, transit bar, etc. During cargo loading, in order to maintain LNG carrier tank pressure, high duty compressor being used to send excessive vapor from cargo tank. vapor is returned to LNG terminal. The vapor being sent to flare stack to be burned, or it is depend into the terminal procedures about how to handling vapor from LNG carrier. Loading quantity is about 98% to 99% of cargo tank capacity. The cargo calculation using CTMS or Custody Transfer Measurement System. Upon completion of cargo loading, bonding cables, optical cable to be disconnected, and water curtain to be stopped. Marine loading arm to be disconnected after methane purging and secure on its place. And then 1 hour notice given for preparation of the engine after marine loading arm clear and propeller clear. Manual spinning and auto spinning done for warming up main turbine. And after about 1 hour warming up, main turbine is ready to carry out dry engine. Or it is depend into the propulsion engine equipped for LNG carrier. It could be steam turbine, DFDE, electric propulsion motor. 1 hour notice is required for preparation for leaving port. Following to pilot on board and gangway unrigged, then main turbine ahead and astern motion tested. When confirmed that ahead and astern propulsion test under normal condition, then notification of standby engine given and unberthing operation started. During releasing of the mooring line, 3 tugboats pushing LNG carrier in order to keep LNGC touch the terminal jetty, prevent LNG carrier from movement and keep the heading. All mooring lines on the forward half and spring has been cast off safely. The releasing sequence of the mooring lines depend into master decision. For details of unberthing process, please watch my video Unberthing of Huge Mouse Type LNG Carrier and FSRU. Pilot then disembark at the pilot station and LNG carrier will start their sea passage. LNG then transported to their destination, whether to FSRU or LNG receiving terminal, for regasification and distribute to the consumer. I think that's all my video. Part 1, story of LNG. There will be another part in near future. Please consider to support my work for creating educational video by subscribe my channel. Your simply support by subscribing my channel is highly appreciated. It will boost up my ideas, create more educational videos. Thank you for watching my video. If you think that my video is useful, please click like and share button. See you in my another video. Bye-bye. The Antonio Project.